Hello. We thank you for your word, God. We just ask, Lord, for blessing in your word to every person. I pray that every heart would be open to God. And if there's anything inside of somebody that's holding them back, I pray that they just let loose of that, even right now, and receive what you have for them. Call it forth right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, turning timidity, this is the title of the message, turning timidity to grit. Turning timidity to grit. Quit asking to get smaller when God has called you to get bigger. When He's called you to get more ignited and empowered and take a hit and bounce back. He's called us to step up. He's called us to step to places we've never gone before. But sometimes our shoulders need to get more broadened spiritually. Doesn't mean that it's easy, because life is tough. In this world, you're going to have tribulation. You're going to have trouble. It doesn't say you might have trouble. It says you will. In this world, you will have tribulation. But God says, take heart. I have overcome the world. I've overcome the world. He's overcome the situations. And if we can start seeing that God has overcome, we're going to start stepping and walking and living differently, because we know God is in control. And He's got me covered. He's got me covered. And I'm coming through these things. So don't lose your tender side. It's easy to kind of like just get tough inside so much you don't open up to anybody anymore. And God wants you to be tough but tender. Tough but tender. Don't lose the tender part. Get rid of the timidity part. Because it says in 2 Timothy 1:7, for the Spirit of God says, I haven't given you a spirit of timidity. I haven't given that to you. That doesn't come from God. Why are we holding on to something that's not what God has for us? Because He says, I didn't give you a spirit of fear or a spirit of timidity. But I gave you one of power, of love, and of a sound mind. A sound mind. So God is calling you and I to embrace what He has. He's given you power, love, and self-discipline. Power, love, and self-discipline. Power, love, and a sound mind. Sound mind. I just declare it over my life. But the timidity part, I don't need that. You see, I'm not saying I've walked through all that. I'm not saying that I never have any timidity in my life. Because sometimes I do. But I'm walking through it, and I'm starting to embrace the grit that God has called me to. There needs to be a new anointing on you and me. And that is grit. Spiritual grit. Somebody's got to be strong. Might as well be you. Amen. Might as well be you. Step up for others. Step up for others. Let them see that you're not falling apart, even though you've gone through hell and high water. You've gone through the difficulties, but you're standing your ground because you got grit. You got some grit inside, and you're not going to quit. That's what God has called us to. I'm not all that, but I'm getting there. I'm getting there because I'm choosing not be a quitter. I'm not a quitter. I don't give up. I stay the course. I stay the course. And I see God working in my life. Well, look at all the stuff that you're going through. Like you should have given up a long time. No, I'm not a quitter. I got some grit, but I got some more grit coming. Come on, God, bring it on. Give me stronger. So, thick skin, but a soft heart. Thick skin, but a soft heart. I can take a hit, taking a hit, but I still got the tender side. I don't throw away the tender side. Well, I've been hurt by others. I never open up my heart again. No, don't say that. Don't say that. I'm still opening up my heart to the next person. I'm still opening up my heart to somebody else because I'm keeping the tender side. I'm keeping the tender side. Well, I'm never going to church anymore. I went to a church and the pastor was a jerk. So the pastor was this or this situation happened or I'm never going to open up my heart to my family members again because of what my family did to me. Like, nope. I still have the tender side. I'm a forgiver. I forgive my family. I forgive my friends. I forgive my boss at work. I forgive those around me because I got the tough, but I also got the tender. See, you got to be able to take a hit. And sometimes some of us have been weak. We've been tired. We've had the onslaught of nonsense that has continued to hit us, and sometimes it seems like we've been vulnerable to just give up and not allow the tenderness of God to work through our lives to other people. But I'm realizing I'm going to continue to reach out to those around me, even though somebody else told me I'm not a good pastor, and I'm not good this, and I'm not a good that. And the next person I open my heart to, how can I help you? How can I be there for you? Because the next person doesn't deserve what happened from the last person. From the last person, what they've done. So I step up and I get some more grit. Anybody with me today on this? Come on now. We gotta grab onto that grit. Timidity is shy and nervous. But you know, we need to say to that shy and nervous, take a hike in the presence of God and head to oblivion, to the eternal place of no return. And come on, get out of my life. Get out of my life. That is the timid, the fearful attitudes. My family members have a tendency of having fear and worry in their lives. And I have to go, nope, not going there. Not going there. It doesn't matter who my family, doesn't matter what situation, I can break generational curses. I don't have to follow the pattern of someone else. I'm going to follow the pattern of God Almighty in my life. How about you? Yes. Come on, get that and then watch us be a blessing because the grit of God is working inside of you to bless other people and help others around us. Amen. The word grit is courage and resolve. Courage and resolve. It is strength of character. Strength of character. It sounds good. That's what we should be having for our life. There's this movie. It's called True Grit. There needs to be some true grit inside of you today. Well, I would, but I just don't have it. Okay? Well, now receive it. God, give me some more grit. I don't have it, but I want it. God says that if you ask for wisdom, He'll give it to you. He'll give it to you gladly. If you ask from God, He's going to bless you and give to you the desires of your heart and make all your plans succeed. Ask Him for some more grit to get tougher on those things and let loose of the things that's been hard to shake off of you. Hard to shake off. Shake it off. Dust it off and move forward with more grit in our life. In your spirit, say, not my will, but God's will be done. Think what Jesus has done on the cross. He didn't want to do it. He didn't want to go to the cross. He didn't just say, oh, I'd gladly just get beat up and destroyed. No, Jesus, but he looked through it. At first he says, if you take this cup from me, please do. But he said, but not my will. But not my will, but your will be done. And you know, we need to have that attitude. It's like, God, your will be done. Can you say with me, your will be done. God's will in our life. Allowing God to work. And that's what God has called us to. Take an exit today from timidity. Take an exit. Don't miss the exit. There's a big sign that says, exit timidity. Come on, get it out of you. Get it. Do not step in the area of timidity. Say, I choose not to be someone going to walk in timidity anymore. Because that's not my call. Because God did not give me a spirit of timidity. He didn't give it to me. And why would I want to walk with something that's not from God? Because what's from God is good. And that's what God wants us to do, is receive the things that's going to be good for our life. Galatians 6:9, let us not become weary in doing good. At the proper time, you're going to reap a harvest if you don't give up. You're going to reap a harvest if you don't give up. You carry within you the full arsenal of God, and you don't even know it sometimes. You're loaded. You're loaded and you don't even know it.
That's right.
You're a warrior. There's a warrior spirit inside of you.
Amen.
And sometimes we're not stepping into it because we've been looking at the timidity part. We're going like, I just kind of feel. If you just go by feelings, there's a song, I'm not going to sing it, but it says feelings, nothing more than feelings, not going that way. I'm not just going to go by my feelings. I'm going to go by my commitment to what God's word says for my life. And he says, he didn't give me a spirit of timidity, but one of power, of love, and of a sound mind. That's what God has given for me. Power-packed victory is yours. Power-packed victory. That's what God has called for you and I. Power-packed. No one else is designed like you. To have how you shine in this world. No one else is designed like that. You have something inside of you so amazing that the devil doesn't want that to be working. Doesn't want that to be activated. Because how you uniquely shine to others, no one else can touch what you can do. You got that uniqueness of God inside of your life. And the enemy doesn't want that, so he wants to stop that. He wants to stop that in your life. Every one of you are so unique. I can influence people that you might not be able to influence, but you can influence people that I can't influence because of the uniqueness of God powerfully working in our life. You are a lion.
Amen.
Lion of the tribe of Judah. Amen. Lives inside. Everyone that called on the name of Jesus has Jesus in their heart. And he's from the lion. He's the lion of the tribe of Judah. You got a lion inside of you that roars.
Amen.
We're not talking about a dandelion. We're talking about a lion. A lion that roars. True grit inside of you and me. That's what we have. Hebrews 10:36 says, you need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you'll receive what He's promised. Persevere. Persevere. There's a new spiritual impartation that God wants to give today to you. Would you receive it? Would you receive it?
Amen.
Because I believe that I'm talking to a group of people that has needs, just like myself. Same as myself. When this message is going out, I'm pointing back at myself because I need it for my own life. I'm hungry for growth. I'm hungry for change. Amen. I'm hungry to be everything that Jesus Christ has called me to be. Amen. And I want that for my life. So I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to be held back because of the hurts of my past. I'm putting that behind me. It's going to the place of oblivion. And I'm stepping forward today, walking out of timidity and walking into a grit that I haven't had before. Broaden my shoulders, God. It says in Matthew 7:14, the way is hard that leads to life. It's hard. It is hard. But God wouldn't give anything to you that you can't do without His help. He knows you can win. He knows the ability of Him working with you and in you through your life, what kind of impact that He can do through your wonderful self. And that's what God is trying to get into us today, I believe. You know, thinking about a pearl is developed in an oyster and through agitation. Some foreign substance got inside that oyster and it's kind of wreaking havoc because it wasn't supposed to be there. But the oyster secretes, it's called nacre. It protects that oyster. And what happens is a pearl is formed. A pearl is formed. And there's pearls to be formed inside of you. But there's an agitation that gets into your life. And that's okay. Because all of us have them. Those agitations. It's what you're going to do with them. Are you going to allow that agitation to actually springboard you to a pearl, to make you to be who God's called you to be and bring beauty out of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and the garment of praise instead of the spirit of heaviness. God wanting that to happen inside of our life. The relentless win. The relentless win.
Amen.
Come on now. We got to be relentless. Just be strong in the grace that's in Christ Jesus. Grit is not genetic. It is it's acquired character. It's character that's developed. And that's where the grit is developed. Faith is what God is putting inside of us. And it says in the Word of God, Hebrews 11:6, without faith it's impossible to please God. It's impossible to please Him without faith. It says those who come to God must believe that He exists and He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. He rewards those. So God is calling you to faith. And so it's a gritty faith. Faith is gritty. It's something that you got to hold on to and press into when you don't feel like it. You just keep holding on to faith and watching God work. Allow the gritty faith to work today inside of your life. Because without faith, it's impossible to please God. Why? Why? Because God knows that He can work through a person who has faith. That faith being activated inside of you and I is going to do great exploits. It's going to do great things. But if we don't walk in faith, then we actually stymie the work of God in our life. And God is calling us to hold on to faith. I remember fishing with my dad by Deception Pass, and I had many experiences that I thought maybe I was going to heaven out there. So my dad would have these boats that are just kind of like, really? We're going to take this out to sea? You know, and my dad goes, look, he goes, I worked on it. I spent some hours on it. It's fine. There's a bunch of leaks in the boat. And so I got a bunch of pencils. So I want you to poke the pencils. When you see the geysers of water shooting up in the boat, I want you to put a pencil in it. And I go, great, we're going to have a fun time. So we catch a bunch of fish, throw them in the boat. I'm bailing water while we're fishing. Catch a fish, and fish are swimming around, splashing me when we're out there inside the boat. And yeah, quite an experience. But the most challenging part of the whole thing was the motor. The motors didn't work very well with my dad. So we a lot of times the motor would quit and not start. So we're out there, and it's like, it started a few minutes ago. I don't know what's going on here. So it's like my dad is like tearing the motor apart, and we're starting to drift. We have these little oars are hard to row in a 18-foot boat, and the tide is just about ready to shift, and it's going to take us out to sea, and there's nobody around. And so I see this island close by, and I'm going to get to the rocky, slimy rocks over there, and throw me the rope. And my dad says, okay, what are you going to do? I said, I am going to walk along the cliff of the slimy rocks with barnacles all over them, and I'm going to work my way hours upon hours to walk the cliff along toward Bowman's Bay, where we launched. And we're talking probably 3 hours of climbing on the rocks through there. So my choice was climb the rocks or drift out to sea. What, your decision? I decided I'm climbing the rocks. So he threw me the rope. We're talking about an 18-foot heavy boat, and I'm tying a rope around me, and I'm pulling it as I'm climbing along the cliff. I fell a few times, landed on barnacles and hard rock, jammed it in my hands. I still, for years later, I had a little barnacle stuck inside my skin. It was still there. It's gone now after 80 years ago when it all happened. No, not 80, but probably 25, 30 years ago or more. Probably 40 years ago when that happened. But I had to get some grit because I didn't want to climb a cliff for 3 hours. And pulling a boat while the current is still trying to pull the boat out because the boat's in the water. And I have this long rope, and I've fallen various times, bruised up, barnacle-infested Bryce climbing along the rocks. But the grit of not quitting helped us to get to our destination. About 3 hours later, I got to Bowman's Bay. I got to safe harbor. I got to a place where there's no current. Got to a place where I jumped out and I actually put my dad on my back. He's 6'2", 220 pounds. He didn't have any waders on. And I says, I'm getting out I stepped out, and it was the tide was way out at Bowman's Bay, and I said, "Get on my shoulder." My dad goes, "No way." I said, you can't do that." I says, "Get on my shoulder," and I packed my dad to shore. I packed him to shore. Why? Because I had some grit. I don't always have that grit, but I'm developing it. And I challenge you today. Get some grit, because you're going to win. God says that he's no respecter of persons, and he rewards those who earnestly seek him. And God is going to bless you abundantly, You got a lion inside of you. His name is Jesus. Call on him today. Would you stand as we close? Who receives the word today? Receive the word? Thank you, Jesus. I'm not going to call anybody up today on there, but right where you're at as I'm praying, if you just kind of reach out to God and some area, God, you and God know what's going on in your life and everything. If there's some things you go like, you know what, I need to step up here. I need to step up there. I've been a little bit, no, I'm not called to wimpiness. I'm not called to being wimpy. That's not who I am. You know, I'm called to win and be a champion. And I put my guard down here in this area. If there's anything that you feel like kind of held back on a little bit or haven't pressed in, remember that God did not give you a spirit of timidity, but one of power, of love, and of self-discipline. And just, would you just, as we pray, would you just kind of release it to God? Say, God, I just give you, that area. And I just ask you to embrace me afresh, anew. I thank you, God, for the victory of Jesus Christ in each person's life. And I thank you, God, that we win. Amen. We're overcomers, yes, by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Yes. Yes. We overcome. And that's what I'm going to walk in. Because God has given me the favor. His favor is resting on my life. So I just call it in. I call it in right now for each person. I call it in to receive it, what God has. I just thank you, God, that you are my strength, you are my song, and you are my deliverer. My deliverer. And I thank you for that. I call it in for each person's life today. Letting loose of something that's not from God, because timidity is not from God. Come on now.
Yeah. Thank you.
And I just receive what God has for my life. Strength and love and of a sound mind. Call it in right now in Jesus' name. Yes. Amen. 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 All right. God bless everyone. Thank you for being in the house today. Jerry, did I forget anything? Okay, is it a short leader meeting? Thank you. Jerry is key to keep me on track. So I really appreciate you, Jerry.
Likewise.
Thank you. All right, God bless you all. Thanks for being in church. Your time is valuable. And thank you that you made God's house a priority today. God bless you. Thanks for being here.